Welcome back, ladies and gents, to the secondary stream here for DreamHack Winter 2014 Group B and D play here with me, DDK, and Avela, of course. We just saw loads of games, all nuke. Well, guys, this is basically the stream of nukes because we've got more nuke coming up, watching, which is crazy.
Yeah, you're watching DreamHack Winter denuke.
Yeah, I mean, the crazy thing is that they each view to a map, pool of seven maps.
Yeah.
Random, and then it nuke.
It's
rigged.
But it's really scary that Nuke decides, well, this match specifically, Nuke is going to decide whether you have a chance of becoming in the legendary sticker group for the next major, which is like between $50K and $100K.
And it's a lot on the line. That's real money. That's hard money.
So far, it seems like the CT side, if you start off on the CT side, you just win. So the knife round has never been worth so much. It is so, and we missed the knife round. It's so important. Dignitas have won the knife round this time round.
Did it again?
Yeah, they'll be starting off on the CT side. So I buy power. Will they break this curse? Where whichever team starts on the T side pretty much loses.
I like this. Swag. He's got the CZ and the smoke. I love the CZ smoke. It's so good. So good.
Armor on the CTs. Zipnix has the nades. Cajun B again with the defuse kit, just like when they played their first match against Penta. And this time they're against a bit more of a formidable opponent. It won't be as easy to hold down as before. Dupree here. Cajun B lands a really nice shot all the way from heaven towards outside. Oh, he does have no idea, Swag, that Cajun B's still there. He gets one frag on Zipnix, but that's not enough. Nitro. Sorry, not Swag, Skadoodle. Swag's still alive. Dupree will make short work of Nitro there. And bottom is Secret. Swag. Pushing up the PTJ. Run out of quality on the CZ, and Fetish will finish him off. Team Dignitas win the pistol round. We'd expect that on the CT side of Nuke. Now they'll be able to go for a full buy. I buy power without the bomb plant. They should go for a CZ armor buy. That's probably what they're going to do now.
Oh my god, Zipnix repping the Oomp. He is repping the Oomp. The Oomp is
the Oompa-Loompa.
Since that SMG buff not so long ago, it's actually a formidable weapon, especially against armored opponents, as we can see. That's actually what they're facing up against as well. So there is that smoke hit against the curve, and that always kind of lands just in, like, inside the door there, which is really nice positioning.
Yeah, it's nice.
As you can see, he's got like a really good kind of little cavity to aim into. I'm seeing some good nade damage coming onto Ivar as well as they go for the upper play.
Getting completely shut down by Dignitas. With the three franks.
Ivar did this in their last match. Remember how well it worked.
The execute?
Yes, against Copenhagen Wolves. They just did that upper play and they just like got the frags. And I remember saying, so well, that wouldn't happen against Team Dignitas because, you know, we've seen, you know, they have such tight setups, they had the counter grenades. We saw exactly that. They just locked down the site with counter grenades. They did the damage, they had the good positions, they knew what was happening ahead of time. And that's the experience that they bring to the table as such a solid lineup for so long.
Full eco. It's probably going to be an A execute as Nitro saw down that smoke in towards the A site. Flash through, the fight doesn't get flashed, he's ready. He'll get flashed by the second flash though. Fetish is there in support and he misses his shot, however. Oh, finishes off AZK with that one shot from the CZ. Zipnix with a frag, Cajun B takes down Swag, and Vice finishes off. Good job. Team Dignitas with the third round.
Something I noticed there actually from Device's positioning on floor, they know that it's going to be a Glock train somewhere in that round.
Yep.
And if you're actually on heaven with the M4 and people actually come out of heart if you're doing heart, it's actually like really difficult sometimes because you've only got 20 bullets to actually get the kills, because you need to get like a headshot and like another bullet on them. So it's kind of difficult. So actually being on floor is like the best way to engage that situation.
Yeah,
and
of course.
So it's a really nice position. Just a little thing to mention.
Full buy now coming in from the terrorists. Skadoodle, no armor, just an AWP. This round will really test Team Dignitas' defenses for the first time in this map. Nuke again. We've seen it twice before. Dignitas beating Pentai by power. Better off Copenhagen Wolves. Skadoodle. Checking.
They're waiting for Skadoodle to make a pick. It's on the Skadoodle, but action force on outside as the push came in from Dignitas, and we see the trades go back and forth. And Dignitas down a man.
Yep, for the benefit of Armour Power, that little trade. Desi goes down, but Dupree and Fetish in return. Zipnix is waiting. Skadoodle. He's on the left side, and he won't be peeking deep in the side. Zipnix has to be really careful here. Really, really careful, because if he gets shot down by Skadoodle, It'll probably be the round for I by Power Skirtoodle. He's right next to him. He's millimeters away. Step next. He sees him. He gets the headshot. The final bullet actually going through the box there. Millimeters, literally millimeters between him and Skirtoodle. And they will push regardless. Zipnix backs away after making that frag. It's 3-on-3. Now it's a bit more manageable here for the CTs as the terrorists push in towards the B site. Zipnix is in long B. Sees, actually doesn't see them. We'd expect them to see, but that's because we see the X-ray. Swag trying to do a cheeky thing by pushing the A site, the upper site. But KJMB is ready for him. Now it's 3-2 and I by Power. Their attack is breaking down. They're going to try and go for the A-site push and try and plant the bomb. They don't have a lot of time left, and KJMB has to be careful here. He will be able to drop down the bomb. So it is a round 4, Team Dignitas. Device finishing off AZK, so no weapons to be saved as well, as Team Dignitas will win the first buy round for IMI Power, and it's 4-0.
It's a really nice approach, a very risky approach from Dignitas there, where they're actually just deciding to push outside with a couple of players, and obviously, this can go really, really wrong if they don't. And it actually kind of did go a little bit poorly for them.
They lost two.
They traded 2-for-1, which is terrible on the CT side. But we'll come back to that fort later on now, as we're seeing I by Power bringing in the CZ. Three flashes to work with. It's going to be a fast one here after that.
Oh, yeah. Vice throws down that smoke, deep nade towards lobby.
Good smoke, that's going to stop far that nade. Counter grenades for days from Dignitas, always going to throw a wrench into the works on these quick plays.
They're just going to go for a fast rush towards Ramai through the smoke. KJMB ready for the move. He runs out of bullets, then he has to go back to reload. He only gets one frag on Desi. Zipnix forces him. They force Zipnix to go back, but this time they're not going towards the B site. In fact, they're retaining outside. He has to be really careful, Fetish, because they could push him outside, and he's not looking at that angle. I don't think there's any CT to protect his back. Zipnix. He's in a good position, if that smoke dissipates, to get an easy frag on one of the iBuy Power players, but he actually backs away. iBuy Power do have control of ramp now, and with 50 seconds left on the clock, it's up to AZK to make the right choice. Will they go towards A site from heaven? Will they push towards the B site? Will they back away? In fact, they do back away, and they go all the way to lobby to push towards the A site, with Swag remaining in ramp just to get maybe a flank kill on the CTs. 30 seconds left on the clock. iBuy Power going for an A push. Device is there. He will make the frag on Nitro. Good flash from the CTs. AZK tries to lure the CTs with that squeaky door open, and it is an easy round for Team Dignitas. It had some potential, that push.
I liked what they did there, because by taking ramp, the problem is they didn't get any entries, and that's going to make it a lot more difficult. Being against five players from Dignitas, but the kind of theory there, I think, from deciding to go back and hit upper, is that if they have ramp, the threat on lower was immediately there. So Dignitas are likely to relieve themselves of the positions on catwalk and drop to floor. And if they're on floor, it's much easier to fight them with the CZs than if they're up, you know, up in the sky, you know, shooting down on them. So they try to make their engagement a little bit easier, but they didn't get the entries they needed.
It was clever. It was a smart play from KJMB and Zipnix as well, not going down and losing that.
Oh, he expected it from Fetish. Do you remember last time?
Yeah.
Fetish is doing that over and over again. Finally gets punished.
Yeah, Skirtoodle, a bit too smart for him there. Was ready for that. Boost will come up. He can jump on.
Oh.
He has to make this jump. AZK. Oh, it's epic. He doesn't make it. He falls down. Loses a bit of health, but he gets a frag on Dupree anyway. Device. Oh, this is really important from Device. Great push through Secret to get himself two frags, drop the bomb, and that's the T side. That's the round for iBuy Power broken down completely. I mean, they looked great. They already had two frags. They were one or two men up. But now with the bomb down, AZK remaining.
He's got a very strong chance to do this, though. He's against two players with M4s and 40 seconds.
He's rambling this.
The problem is the bomb, though. It's one player on it, Device. Over by Secret. AZK needs to get...
They're not defending it well at all. And for some reason, he probably should have known that Device was going to be there somewhere. And he tried to quickly jump. Perhaps not to get shot from main. Maybe that's what he was trying to do. Just like move really quickly.
Yeah, it's very... They can be in so many positions there. It's really difficult.
6-0, iBuy Power. They'll be able to afford a full buy this time as well. Team Dignitas are looking solid on the CT side. It's every player's nightmare to play Dignitas on Nuke with them playing on the CT. Actually, any CT side of map with Team Dignitas on the CT side, especially if they start off on the CT side as well. Zipnix again on ramp. Dupree in the same position as he was and the rounds before and in the map before as well. They're gonna push once more. They do have a few nades and smokes and flashes. Skadoodle holding ramp.
He needs to get the entry there. A lot is relying upon Skadoodle to get that shot.
Actually, gonna be, might be a force ramp. They do have to call a ramp. Zipnik's force back. Cajun B as well. Force back. Morphos gonna go down to try and slow them down. And Zipnik's actually holding a pretty advanced position here. Could be able to steal a frag, but they give away his position with those bullets that he just fired. Cajun B still holding the A site just in case one of the terrorists does go for that little backstab. Fail nade. Nice shot, we'll make a frag. This is a good start here for iBuyPower. Two entry frags in towards the B site. Cajun B takes down Nitro, who's going for that little flank. Now iBuyPower, with complete control of the B site, will be able to get the bomb planted. But oh, look! Look who's here! Look who's hiding through Toxic. I think they're aware of that. They open up the door. And they will get the frag on Zipnik's. The defense, the CT defense of Team Dignitas has finally been broken down by iBuyPower with that ramp push. Well timed as well.
Yeah, there was a key frag by Skadoodle over and along. Like, there was a one-on-one that he had, and rounds can just come down to these one-on-ones, and Skadoodle was the guy that had the key one. He got the kill against the player who was on the stairs in long. If he doesn't get that kill, then they don't have long. If they don't have long, then their chances to win that round go down dramatically. So big props to Skadoodle there to actually make execute on that one-on-one.
Yeah, and I think it's also to do with the fact that Zipnik and KGB did not land their shots over on that. That's part of it as well. And it's iBuyPower's luck. If Zipnik and KGB are landing the shots in ramp, you cannot push ramp. It's very, very difficult. And also Zipnik was caught kind of in a poor position. I think he was either flashed, but something caused him to back away. Maybe he failed to score. But KGB coming in from the CT spawn side of ramp, he just didn't land any shots. So he fought back as well. But around for iBuyPower, it's 6-1. It's a good start for them. Maybe they can build from this. Maybe they can capitalize from this win and build a bit of momentum against Team Dignitas. And best case scenario, if they win a few more rounds, perhaps even force them onto an eco and get a free round from them. Fetish ready and waiting. Thanks to Desi. Good dynamic CT play here by Team Dignitas. They've got CTs holding different positions all the time. Keep iBuyPower guessing.
Yeah, making the move now to ramp, but Fetish repositioning. Just a shot.
What a shot. That is actually an amazing shot from Fetish.
It was a 3-on-5 though, and Dignitas, they already know what's going on. They have more than enough players, if they are positioned correctly, to deal with this. Zipnik's in device. Beautiful stuff there on the defense. iBuyPower felt very pressured to try to create something from nothing and didn't quite get so lucky. And 7-1 now the score, and the bank broken still for iBuyPower.
Yep.
What are they to do?
What are they to do? Team Dignitas, again, showing how dynamic they are on the CT side. Sometimes when they're backing away, they play really deep in the B side. Sometimes they stay really close to those two little doors. And that really, really keeps iBuyPower guessing. It's very difficult because you have to check every single angle. And once that happens, you start second-guessing yourself and you can't really play smooth terrorist play. You know, you can't push fast. You keep thinking, oh, maybe he's here, maybe he's hiding there. And it'll definitely slow you down. Now Dignitas with 7 rounds. They have stopped iBuyPower from building up momentum economically as well, and they've been stopping them for a while. So, device. I don't know what he was thinking, jumping down in front of their bullets, but Dupree's there to pick up the slack regardless. He'll get 2 frags on Swag and Nitro. 8-1.
So, the boy coming in again for iBuyPower. It was very unlikely to get anything done in the previous round, but as we can see, they should have an ample amount of grenades in this round.
Yep.
And really, the pressure comes on. The thing that I find interesting is we're not seeing really a wall of smokes outside to kind of remove Fetish.
Push the secret, yeah.
Because Fetish has been on those angles repeatedly. They don't even have to push outside, but just having the smokes down and just forcing that situation where Dignitas don't get the information, that gives them more to play with. So iBuyPower are actually making the move outside with a few players. I think they're actually getting somebody up on the main. They do have Swag, kind of lurker, over in lobby, just catching any rotations, and the rest of the team comes in. And look, there are the smokes I was just talking about.
Just as you said it. There's all the smokes outside. Dupree will get a frag on AZK through the smokes device, waiting for that flank from Swag. He'll make the frag. I think they tried to do like a split towards B, one from ramp and the rest coming in from secret, and it's not really worked out for them. Completely shut down again. Alright, we'll get 1 frag on device, however. We can do more damage. As Team Dignitas make it 9-1. Some really, really solid play. And that's the thing, against Dignitas, even if you go for the secret play, You're not sure. Sometimes they have a guy in secret. Sometimes they don't. Sometimes the guy outside is in the main garage. Sometimes he's on heaven.
Yep.
So even if you throw down that smokes, you can still get shot. Like if Fetish was holding balcony and he was looking down, they'd still get shot regardless. So it's that's probably why they haven't really tried to go outside so much.
One point though, at least they can eliminate that as the only place to look.
Yeah, exactly. That's true. So they only have to check that angle. Fetish is outside this time. He needs to shot on Desi. Actually, players need to stop doing that jump over the box. It doesn't work when you're against a good AWPer. He'll shoot you anyway.
Actually, every single AWPer looks for that shot these days. Yeah. Like even when I'm playing, I always look for that shot. And even I can get it frequently enough because you know it's coming.
Yeah.
Like you know it's coming. You don't need the best reactions in the world. So it's definitely something you got to be careful about.
And,
I think players want to use grenades more because it's kind of greedy in the sense that it's like, oh, I'm going to try to get some free information. Which is really cool. So we'll have to see if either power able to adapt it. Obviously, Dignitas are ready for them to take outside and are ready for them to smoke outside and for them to not have information. They know how to deal with that. That's what they've shown either power already. So it's going to come down to either power finding a fast round or I think just getting that situation where they get the picks. But so far, Dignitas so strong individually. It's almost scary to watch.
Exactly. Device picking up the role that we expect him to pick as a top fragger. He's the most talented player here in Dignitas, and he's definitely a player to watch out for in this tournament. Fetish is really giving a good argument for being one of the top CT side AWPers in this game. He's really holding those angles, and he's not missing his shots. I mean, it's really rare to see Fetish miss those shots when they're pushing whatever angle he's holding. So he's doing an excellent job here. It's been very, very hard for Eye Power to really push in any part of the map. Oh, Cajun B actually misses his shots for the second time here on this map, and it could be the opening that Eye Power have been looking for. They're going towards the A site. Zipnix comes in to support, but Cajun B is still alive. He gets one frag for being shot down here by Skadoodle. Device there in support to take down AZK. Fetish will make short work of Desi. And there's barely enough health between Skadoodle and Swag. Really do much that Molotov. It's gonna. Ooh, it doesn't burn anyone. Oh, it does. Oh. It does burn Skadoodle. Oh, it spreads and burns, and the bomb actually doesn't get planted by Eye Power as well. Skadoodle really nicely BBQ. Done by Dignitas. That could have been a round for Eye Power had they been able to capitalize on Cajun B's missed spray.
I'm surprised they didn't get that. That's actually the weakness of having the M4 up there. Is that if they do come through and you don't get the quick one or two kills, you're definitely going to die because you just don't have the bullets. So you just don't have the bullets.
That's what's
and,
the silence.
And the angle is kind of weird to get the headshot sometimes. So it's something that perhaps Eye Power can try to think to try to abuse in the future, but like a delayed upper take with some grenades planted correctly, like the old LDLC used to do. We'll have to see though if they're... Oh, again!
Again!
When will Fetish not punish that? So
it's
far,
like he's playing whack-a-mole, man. He's like...
I think
he jumps, bam.
He's hit that shot like 4 or 5 times, if not missing them at all. So,
oh, nicely done by AZK, actually. Just as you say that, he takes down Fetish. You jinxed him, mate. DDK, you jinxed Fetish.
Never, he's on my dream team. He's actually on my dream team.
He's so happy, he's getting so many points from this.
He's a defensive player for me, so he gets the extra points.
A lot of points from playing on the CT side. I buy power. They've lost Desi, but they've taken on Fetish, so... They might be pushing outside. KGMB's there in support.
Throwing flashbang.
Terror's right above
throwing
him.
Throwing fire.
He gives away his position. Device.
Flashbang.
ZK looking in the wrong place, wrong time. Dupree take down Nitro.
Oh,
Skadoodle. He tried to poke at that, but KGMB turns around, so he had to make that frag and give away his position. It's 3-on-2. Device, oh, really nicely done by Device. That is really smart play. Actually, I think he saw Swag as well, but he heard the other terrorist, so he goes, right, I'm going to push for the guy who's in lobby anyway, and then I'll deal with Skadoodle later.
Nasty crossfire.
He's trying to get the bomb, but there's a beautiful crossfire set up by Team Dignitas. 12-1, completely shutting down Eye Power. It looks like Team Dignitas are on their way, securing themselves a spot in the round of 8.
The funny thing is that a lot of people don't want to see Cobble, but seeing Nuke is almost like quite a similar situation. Like Cobble, like is so hard to take T rounds. Although that said, actually, with a lot of the top teams, they start to they rack up rounds on the T side now. So as people are starting to learn to play the new Cobble, it is not really being a CT sided as it once was. And so we'll see now if you're gonna go for it. He will
go for it. Really, oh, really nice. Oh, drops the bomb as well.
Throwing
That is so ballsy. That's the stuff you can do when you've got a big advantage, a big lead on the money and the rounds. You can go for those risks. He only has to do that one time, and it just has to be like a key moment, and then that's it. I'm not sure we'll take the pre-down though, and they aren't even, but that is going to help them a little bit.
I mean, if I can play, he can do that. He can definitely take those risks. And he's picking up the frags now. He's got a great score. He's getting that confidence, and he's a player you don't want to be confident. You don't want him to be in his game. You don't want him to be able to play in his element. And he's definitely a player that a lot of these teams are fearing. Fetish now. And what a shot on Desi. I mean, did he even see him? I have no idea. He must have seen like a millimeter of that person's body. So I'm making that
shot.
Put
a Terminator vision on, man.
X-ray vision.
Telling you, Fetish is the Terminator. Actually, well, I have to stick to my thing. Like, my thing for Fetish is that he's the drill sergeant.
The who?
The drill sergeant.
The drill sergeant.
Yeah. No, he is the drill sergeant. That's like his like.
He's the drill sergeant.
Yeah, he's the drill sergeant of Dignitas. That's like my little nickname for Fetish.
And how do you know he's a drill sergeant?
Well, I mean, he's brutal.
Is it because he's bald?
He's brutal. I guess he kind of has that look. He's very pragmatic, very focused, very to the point, very blunt. And he definitely, I'm sure, has a very tight grip of what his team should be doing.
Throwing smoke.
So yeah, that's based on the way he looks.
Just gonna go for looks, all right? But
based on the way look, I've never met the lad, so I can't really tell you. But based on his looks, he does look like a drill sergeant.
Yeah, I think it fits.
I don't know how Skadoodle survived that shot from Fetish, that Terminator orb shot from the drill surgeon, if you want to call him that. Ramp control does go towards I by Power, and Desi's actually going to make the frag on Fetish, who probably didn't have anyone to have his back. Spray through Skadoodle. Oh, he's ready for Zipnix. Zipnix tried to do a cheeky one and push back and regain control of Ramp, but it's not going to work out for him. Zipnix will go down to Skadoodle. Now they do have a chance of winning this round. Swag takes down Dupree. Swag this time playing as well. What is he doing? He has got the bomb as well.
Oh my god.
No, did he throw away this round?
Oh, the jump in for
I can't
well.
Believe it. Why did he op himself through the window with the bomb? What is he doing?
I don't know, man. Ineffable. There's no words for that.
Maybe he just thought he was playing Quake for a moment.
This,
like, this,
is why,
all right,
this is why I think in CSGO, I think Valve should add this, where that if you're jumping through a window, you should be able to like jump kick through the window, and don't have to switch like another gun or something. You can like jump kick.
You know what would be a sick use of that kick is if there's a guy on heaven and you're right behind him and he doesn't have a lot of health and you just kick
like
him.
Like a
his
this death. Is Sparta moment.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Well, I guess you can't say Sparta, but
this is
Dignitas.
Counter Strike. I don't know. I don't know. I can't really think of one. But that would be a sick. I like a kick. Like press K for kick. That'd be good.
Yeah. But we're gonna get like slowly like closer and closer to like Call of Duty every day. If we start like adding these things.
You so can, like, scope down the AK and stuff.
Exactly.
Oh,
like,
God no.
The iron sights coming in. Man, iron sights. I'm not a fan of iron sights. The whole like concept of iron sights. I don't like it.
I think they'd be good, but they make the accuracy of guns too good on other games. Like, you just fire how much you want and nail down.
I just don't like it. It just takes skill out of the game. I mean, it's like a zoom. You just get a zoom, get more accurate for free. There's
but
not,
I mean, if
like
it's,
no,
it depends
no
on the iron sight. If it's like a scoped iron sight, yeah. But if it's like a normal, just a metal piece, and it just changes the...
It zooms you, and then basically...
I mean, it doesn't have to zoom you, but it like focuses the gun in the middle. So that basically it changes the crosshair, technically. Then maybe it's okay. But if it's like one of those normal where it just zooms in, gives you a red dot, and just like fire to kill, then yeah.
Well, I mean, what can you expect? Well,
you know what's great? We're casting Counter-Strike. Yep. So none of that business.
No iron sights.
And I'm sure some of you guys are probably coming from Call of Duty and probably maybe you're watching Counter-Strike for the first time. So welcome. You know, welcome. You're watching DreamHack Winter 2014. Hopefully you're enjoying it.
I should hope so. I should hope so. Are you not entertained? All this nuke... crazy CT action going on. I'm loving the amount of points Fetish is racking up for me right now on my dream team, so that's
so
going
happy.
Well for me.
So
I love the dream team stuff. This has to happen at every big event. It's so awesome. I love it. It's just so fun. It's just so
it's
fun.
Really, really fun. Yeah, every major event should have a dream team. Thanks to HLTV for setting it up.
I used to do this back in the Brood War days. They used to have this Brood War as well. Yeah. And they had it for StarCraft 2. It's just so good. But we're into the pistol round now. Big ask for I Buy Power on the CT side. And they've all bought some nades. Actually, Swag with some armor. It's going to be very interesting to see if they hold on.
The CZ Zipnik. Oh, very nice. Very fast indeed. Smoke down. Bomb planted. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy here for Dignitas. And if I Buy Power lose this round.
You know what the funny thing is that there were decoys outside.
Penta did a better job than I-Buy Power against Team Liquid Pass. That's a really scary thought for Copenhagen Wolf. Zipnik, yet another kill for him. And it is the round for Team Liquid Pass. I-Buy Power are probably going to go to the lower bracket finals and perhaps play either Copenhagen Wolves or Penta again.
Very interesting stuff. Dignitas with a very strong performance. It's going to be definitely what people expected. I mean, I-Buy Power on paper should not defeat Dignitas. And this result is going to be...
It might have been a different story. It might have been a different story had I-Buy Power started on the CT side. This is something I really want to know because so far in this tournament...
Even if it was like Dust 2 or something, it could have been a much different story.
Yeah, if it was a different map, of course it would have been a different story. But I'm just thinking, so far on this in this tournament, every single nuke, the CT side always wins. The person who starts on the CT side ends up winning the game, so...
It's just the nature of the beast, the random element in this tournament. We are seeing a one-for-one trade going on here, though, as we do see Dignitas down a man. They are together, though, on the ramp area, so there are a lot of options down into that lower side. However, I have a power more than set up to deal with this.
ACK's waiting for them. He has to be patient here. He has to take his time.
Dignitas can go back. They've got plenty of time.
He's going to be looking at the wrong door, I think, here. But he's got his teammate in there. Yeah, he lands a headshot as well. They have to either go through or stay back, because just messing about like that, it's going to get them killed.
The thing is, if they just hit up really fast right now, they're going to force everybody who's down there through the vents. They don't necessarily know how many people are down there, but they just spent so much level of threat, or invest a lot of threat into that site, that they should have rotated everybody. That they should be thinking on these lines. And if they move up heaven and through upper, they
go. SDK's gonna get the strike. Oh, yes, he does. He makes the strike. Oh, what a beautiful shot by Skadoodle. Oh, that scout. That's a nasty scout shot.
Device! Flying through the air. This guy is all over the place. What a round there from I-Buy Power. I mean, Dignitas, it felt like there was a little bit of indecision. They realized they couldn't quite push in. But they didn't make a call soon enough.
The thing is, why are they worried? I-Buy Power on two rounds, just run in. You lose a man, get the frag, make the trade.
Yeah, I really think they're in that position that they can just not care. Yeah. I think that's the very danger of a position like they're in right now, that they shouldn't feel invested or that like they should care, because they are 11 rounds ahead.
Squeaky smoked off. They've not even nade in it. It's a good choice, just in case that nade comes in. They don't have a nade, though. So I think they're going to go for that lower, the vents into B site. And that's what they're
going to do. Oh, just barely not.
They misjudged it, and they got stuck. And Swag's like, oh, what are these two terrorists doing? Just kills them both.
I think they were, like, stuck on each other there. Like, I think, like, they were kind of on the vent, but they were, like, blocking each other, like, inside. Oh, my goodness. But yeah,
we died together.
It was a nice plan, though. I mean, they had the smoke there. They could like kind of run through the smoke, and then there was a smoke and a flash on the guy who could have planted the bomb, so should have been able to get the free plant. And that's what they were playing for, small investment for a potentially big reward. So it was a nice idea from Dignitas.
And so that smoke could have been really bad for the CT side, because that would have allowed them to get in. But I think the smoke was close enough to the door where he could actually see them if they went through vents. Or he could, you know, see them just before they go into vents and maybe make those shots. But through that, a very fast push. The CT forced to back away, and ADK's there. KJMB goes straight towards him. First fire takes him down. Picks up the AK-47, and it's a good start here for the Eco Wing terrorist side.
With the Glock and everything, get a bit of support there from the screen still.
Oh, that wall bang! Oh, the nade. Good night.
Oh,
good
that's
night.
A great nade.
Oh, he's still alive with four health.
I'm gonna see that. So they are gonna be scrambling now, not being able to get up to heaven quickly. Leaves them without many options to turn to, and we're seeing them just sitting there now, walking kind of back towards the ramp area, seeing what they can pick off.
Swag really has to hold this spot here. He has to make those strikes. They're pretty low, the team getting fast plays at the moment. Oh, he gets the wallbang on Zipnix.
The options kind of suck for Dignitas right now. It's very difficult to get onto either site. One of the players, they're looking towards Fetish for this with the AK, has to come out with an opening kill to try to give them an opening onto a site.
Oh, what a shot by Skudud. He had to make that shot. He definitely was able to rise up to that occasion, because had he not made that shot, had he gone down, it could have been a different story. But I-Buy Power with a quick cleanup of the remaining Dignitas players. It was a bit scary. Swag and Skudud both on very low health.
It's good. I don't know how he survived that. I mean, I think that nade, if it was just one, I don't know, just a bit closer to him, he probably would have died. But 14 to 5, Team Dignitas are only 2 rounds away. I buy power, racking up the rounds and.
Come on, chop, chop.
Keeping the morale up, but it's just one mistake. That's all Team Dignitas need. And they'll be able to end this.
And they got the full buy going for themselves. And now it's all about assessing what they think the best option to go for. It's in another fast play. It looks like that's going to be the case. They were moving quite quickly. Did the counter grenades work out?
Yeah.
Really, though, they are still getting into the ramp. AZK is going to back away. So, once again, the real estate of ramp is well and truly owned by Dignitas. The Danger flag planted in there. So, we're looking in from hell. Oh, how did he get that one? That's brilliant. And Dignitas now down a man. And Iber Power still with the. All the control they need. They don't need ramp. We can see they're down lower.
Yeah, you can give away either ramp or outside, one of them, not both. But as long as you know where they are, you're in a good position. Skadoo again with another wall bang. What a shot as well.
Oh,
flash his teammates. Oh, what's going on?
Like this, delaying at this point is very strong because slowly, like another 10-20 seconds, Dignitas are going to be committed, and that's going to be a lot of information that Power can gamble on the lower side or wherever they think.
They've really shut them down in ramp right now. Fetish will take down the flag, pushing towards the site. He'll get yet another frag, and actually, it's really nicely done by Nitro. He went in from lower, and he'll get yet another frag on Nitro. Completely opens up the game for them. Skadoodle!
How did he make that shot on Zipnix? Jumps down, and like as soon as he lands, fires off that shot. Now it's a 2-on-2. It looked like Team Dignitas are in a really good position. But they have to be fast eye by power, because the bomb's planted here.
There's a man in Toxic. It's always very difficult to deal with so few players. Device is the man. Gonna drop down AZK.
And he shuts the door straight after. There's a ramp to come to here. Skibidl doesn't have enough time. He went straight for Device to get that frag, but it's really difficult.
It's a beautiful shot, to be honest. That was a really crazy good shot from Skibidl. I think there are even 2 players on screen as well, and he took the harder shot. So very difficult stuff for Iber Power and Dignitas. I mean, we can see the power of just holding ramp. We've seen that situation before, and we saw it actually kind of sink them previously when it was actually a save for Iber Power, or kind of close to a save. I think they actually invested in some pistols, but this time, much more decisive, much better execution out of the day.
Unlike the map before, it doesn't seem like Desi and Knight were able to get into the element of things and perform as well as they did, because they stopped fragging in the round before.
Oh, wow. That spray from Zipnix.
But Nitro got 3 frags as well. He did a great job with that spray. Now it's a 2-on-1. KGMB remaining. He'll be able to pick up the bomb. Could go towards the B site. He knows what he's going to do here. He might get a cheeky bomb plant as well. But Desi and Swag have to be smart about this. Desi goes before he gets support from Swag. But he'll get the kill regardless and make it 15-6. And as I was saying, now it's Skadoo and Swag who are kind of getting the frags to keep them in the game ever so slightly. And AZK, Nitro, and Desi not doing a great job. Desi only with 5 frags until now. But they were playing on the T side. They only got 2 rounds on the T side. So now they'll be able to rack up more frags. Now they'll be able to get a better economy and perhaps keep Team Dignitas control. But they've already made one mistake and they can't make another. They can play for overtime, I by power. One more mistake in the game. They try to flash themselves through. The Dignitas players, Nitro, will look away and get themselves from that. He's been doing a great job holding down A site, actually.
Bomb has been planted.
The bomb is on the B site. And Team Dignitas, able to get that bomb plant again and again and again, allows them to play more rounds with weapons and just keep the pressure really high against I by power. And they're every round, they're getting kills. Death and Swag down, that's going to hurt their economy as well. And when you're on the CT side, can't make that much money.
Now we can see that their money is not in the best place ever, and 2 drops going to come in so that nades can be bought on those players. It's a really big stretch, that's for sure. And Dignitas on the brink of winning this one. And Molotov and Fetish, actually, I'm curious if there is a specific plan for that Molotov from Fetish. It's always very curious when you see like just a Molotov.
Such a big game. Such a. I mean, a map like. You'd never think that so much money would depend on one map. I mean, it's crazy. You play good. 2 maps, let's say 2 maps. You play good in 2 maps, you've
earned yourself 100k sticker money for the next meet. It's mad.
Those stickers.
It's absolutely madness.
Here we go, the outside play coming in from Dignitas, as they have carpeted the smokes along outside, and they're going
to
make their way down.
Swag to get that frag.
Oh, that's a great reaction.
Very
big frag. Had he not made that frag, there is it's going to be very difficult to get an entry down and keep the pace going. And they have their lurker player. He's waiting to strike in the distraction that's created here by Dignitas on the long area.
Doesn't look too great now for Ivar Power. The one man down. Oh, that smoke was far. He's going to get a frag on Skadoo. Looks like it's probably the end of this map here. It's 4-on-2. The bomb has yet to be planted, but Dignitas are taking their time. Nitro pops up devices there to get the frag. And every single part of the map, they're just out-frying them, getting those 1v1s. And landing those shots all up to Desi here.
He's so far away.
1v4 situation.
Oh my god.
The thing is, the bomb's just been planted here. He knows it's in the B site. And he has to play. He has to play this. It gives away his position in that jump, and they know he's in vents.
Great free fire.
I think the frag on Zipnix. Device is there. He's got a Molotov. Keeping it.
Wow.
Oh, nicely done by Desi. Can he get this round? And I was
just
hyped him up a bit. I thought maybe he could do this, but sadly not. It will end, and it will be the map for Dignitas. They go on to the round of 8. And
sometimes,
as we expected, I guess. As we expected.
Sometimes when people make these pre-fires, a lot of people are like, wow, you know, how did they even do that? Well, in these situations, if he wants to win this situation, he has to get lucky on pre-fires like that, because he's got to be like, okay, I just pre-fired this first guy, got the kill, and if they had four guys left, it's quite likely there's going to be a guy outside of the vents.
Yeah.
So it's like he has to take the gamble right or left there, and he took the gamble right. So there could even have been a guy coming up from upper down into the vents.
Exactly.
So he's just going for the gambles there. I mean, it looks kind of like he's psychic.
Super fast, yeah, or psychic. But he's going for the gambles.
It's calculated gambles. You've got to get the pre-fires in spots like
they've
that.
They've got four players left, so there's bound to be a player in those kind of positions.
Yeah, if they all do damage to you, then like just after each frag, then you're going to go down. Your chances go down dramatically. So exactly. A great display of individual skill, but Dignitas still looking to be the top dogs on these back-to-back new games we've seen so far in Group B. I wonder what the next two matches have in store.
I hope it's not Nuke.
Well, I guess we'll have to wait and see, guys. Have you been enjoying the stream so far here? This is a secondary stream here on Facer TV for DreamHack Winter 2014 for Counter-Strike Global Offensive with me, DDK, and Vela.
Yes.
And it's time for a break. We'll see you in a moment for more matches for Group B.